Om Gyan Tamarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're hearing about Gop Kumar. How he got a mantra from his guru. By the power of his mantra, he was able to travel everywhere.
我们今天继续来聆听 Gopal Kumar 的旅行。他的 guru 赐予他一首 mantra，集中 mantra 的力量，他得以到处旅行。
So, by the power of the mantra, he went to a place beyond the universe. He went into the spiritual sky, and he met Lord Shiva.
那他念着这首 mantra 呢，就旅行到了宇宙之外的灵性天空，在灵性天空，他遇见了主 Shiva。
So when he met Lord Shiva, of course, Lord Shiva is a very special personality and Lord Shiva was with his wife and he was with many associates, but at the same time, Lord Shiva was he was not dressed, he was naked.
主 Shiva 是一位特殊的人物。主 Shiva 和他的妻子和同游们在一起，他是赤身裸体的，他没有穿衣服。
And of course his hair is matted and his body's covered in ashes.
他的头发缠结，他浑身上下涂满了骨灰。
So he was Gop Kumar didn't he didn't know anything about who Lord Shiva was. He'd never heard even of Lord Shiva. So he was introduced that this is Lord Shiva.
Gopal Kumar 并不知道主 Shiva 的身份，他也甚至从来没听说过主 Shiva，所以就有人给他介绍了主 Shiva。
And he was told also that Lord Shiva is not an ordinary person, that he's the same as the Supreme Lord.
他也被告知主 Shiva 可不是普通人，他几乎就跟至尊主一样好。
So, Gop Kumar is a devotee of Madan Gopal, who is the deity of Krishna and Vrindavan.
Gopal Kumar 是Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的神像，Madana Gopal 的奉献者。
And he's always thinking about going back to Vrindavan and being with the Madan Gopal and being enjoying the association of Madan Gopal.
Gopal Kumar 总是想着去回到 Vrindavan 和 Madana Gopal 在一起，享受着和他的联谊。
So when he met Lord Shiva, he was confused, but he told his mind. That he told his mind that actually Lord Shiva, when Lord Gopal is performing his pastimes, that this is Lord Shiva, they're not different. When
Something
Gopal performs his pastimes, these pastimes are actually being done by Lord Shiva.
Gopal Kumar 呢感到有点困惑，但是他就告诉劝诫自己的心说：“Madame Gopal 的消失光呢， 实际上是由主 Shiva 上演从事上演的。
However, the mind, Gopkumar's mind was still not peaceful. It was not settled.
即便如此，Gopakumar 的心意呢，仍然是不安不稳的。
So Gopkumar was speaking to his mind, and he told his mind that if you don't see something in Lord Shiva, if you feel something is lacking in Lord Shiva, then it must be the rare sweetness of Gopal.
于是，Gopakumar 就对自己的心意说："如果你现在仍然在主 Shiva 身上还见不到某些事物，仍然觉得有些缺憾的话，那一定是马当 Gopal 身上所具有的罕见的甜美之情。"
Because Gopal is very beautiful and he has so many wonderful qualities.
因为 Gopal。美丽绝伦，还拥有奇妙的品质。
So then Gopkumar told his mind, he said, by Lord Shiva's mercy, your desire will soon be fulfilled.
Gopakumar 对自己的心意继续说道："急着主 Shiva 的仁慈，你的心愿很快就能达成。"
And you should know, you should feel sure that it's by the special favor of Lord Shiva towards you that this will happen.
他对自己的心意说："你要知道，你应该确信，即使主 Shiva 的特殊仁慈，这件事一定会实现的。
So Gopkumar said, thinking like this, his mind became peaceful. And he was happy to stay by the side of Lord Shiva.
”库马尔这样想了之后呢，他心意就平和起来，他也感到很快乐。他就留在了主 Shiva 身边。
And so, for some reason, Lord Shiva decided to take a rest before continuing his journey.
为了出于某种原因，主 Shiva 决定在继续旅行之前，他要休息一阵子。
So, at this time, Lord Shiva is in the place called Mahakalapura.
在这个期间，主 Shiva 停留在名叫 Mahakalapura 的地方。
And Lord Shiva was going to his own abode, Kailash.
主 Shiva 是要去他自己的居所 Kailash。
But he decided to take some rest for some time.
但是他决定休息一阵子。
But then Gopkumar said, from a distance, he could hear very sweet melodies and the singing of some very great souls.
多帕库马尔说，他远远的就能听到来自伟大灵魂的唱的旋律甜美的歌曲。
So, Gopkumar is actually telling all of this. He's explaining all of this to a person who is his disciple. And this disciple is a Brahmana from Mathura.
这一切，Gopakumar 他在向他的门徒在解释这一切。他的门徒是一位来自 Mathura 的婆罗门。
And Gopkumar is he's actually blessed to be able to engage in the worship of Madan Gopal.
Gopakumar 受到了祝福，能够从事去崇拜马丹的 Gopal。
So Lord Shiva heard that sound. He heard the sound of the singing, and when he heard it, he became ecstatic.
主 Shiva 也听到了这个声音，听到了这个歌曲，主 Shiva 开始变得狂喜。
And when he began, he got up and he began to dance all on his own.
主 Shiva 他便站起身，就开始跳起舞来。
So, the Gop Kumar was not very sure what the sound was, but he saw how it caused transcendental symptoms to awaken in the body of Lord Shiva.
Gopal Kumar 并不知道这个歌曲的内容，但是呢，他从主 Shiva 的表现和他的特征可以看出来，这是一首超然的歌曲。
He could see Lord Shiva's body becoming transformed.
他看出来，主 Shiva 的身体已经转变了。
And in his mind, there was trembling and perspiration, choking of the voice.
他浑身颤抖，就是浑身流汗，他的声音哽塞。
And there was standing of the hairs on end,
他浑
and he
身
was
上下。
falling to the ground as well.
他毛发直竖，他也倒在了地上。
So all of these symptoms appeared spontaneously.
所有的这些特征都是自发的展现出来。
And it he was he could not control the different symptoms. They were beyond his control.
而且所有这些特征展现出来，他也无法自控，他是控制不住的。就展现出来这些特征了。
So Lord Shiva began to dance. Nobody else was dancing around him. But Lord Shiva got up and he started to dance on his own.
在主 Shiva 身边，没有其他的人，但是主 Shiva 一个人自己就站起来开始跳舞。
And Lord Shiva's was with his very faithful wife, his very faithful wife, and his companions. The leader of the companions was a person called Nandeshwara.
主 Shiva 身边是他最忠诚的妻子，还有同游们。这些同游的领袖呢，名字叫 Nandeshwara。
So when they saw Lord Shiva get up and start to dance, they also became very enthusiastic and they began to play music and chant the Lord's names.
当他们看见主 Shiva 起身跳起舞来。这些同游和他妻子也变得满腔热情，也开始弹奏乐器，并且开始跳舞。
So Lord Shiva's wife, Parvati, she's the most faithful of chaste wives.
主 Shiva 的妻子 Parvati 是宇宙中
And when she saw her husband,
最贞洁的妻子。
when she saw her husband in ecstasy, she did not mind. She encouraged him.
当她看见自己的丈夫，开始狂喜起来，她于是更加她不愿鼓励了丈夫。
Even before that, Parvati had been sitting on the lap of Lord Shiva. But when he stood up to dance, began to accompany him with music.
在此之前，帕巴提坐在自己丈夫朱希瓦的大腿上。当朱希瓦起身跳舞的时候，帕巴提便弹奏，就便用音乐来陪伴着他。
So while this was happening, suddenly Gop Kumar saw a group of all very attractive four-armed persons arrive there.
当这一切发生的时候，库玛尔就看到一群人，他们非常有魅力，他们是有着四臂，这些人来到了现场。
And they all had the opulence. They were all young and very beautiful, and you could see they were very good. They had very good fortune.
这些人都是非常富裕的，他们年轻、美丽、英俊，而且他们随身都携带着好运。
So some of the people who were with Lord Shiva. They also had four arms.
有些陪同主 Shiva 的同游也有四臂。
But the people who had just come with the four arms, they were especially very good looking, very attractive, much more than the people who were with Lord Shiva.
而刚刚到来的这些有着四臂特征的人们，他们相貌非常的英俊有魅力，他们的英俊超过了主 Shiva 的同游。
The limbs of their bodies were all effulgent.
他们的四肢，他们的肢体都散发着光灿。
And their bodies were more beautiful than the ornaments which they wore.
他们躯体的美丽，甚至盖过了他们身上的服饰。
And they were so effulgent that all the Shivites, all the people who were with Lord Shiva, they seemed to be invisible.
他们身上发出的光芒是如此的璀璨，以至于主 Shiva 身边的同游们都看不见主 Shiva 的同游了。
But all these four-armed persons were immersed in singing the glories of their Lord.
这些四臂的人物都在专注地唱诵着他们主的荣耀。
Everything about them was very beautiful, all their ornaments and all the things. With them, everything was very, very beautiful.
和他们有关的一切，包括他们的事物，以及他们有关他们的一切都是美丽的。
And Gokumar then saw that along with them, in the company of them, were the four brothers who he had seen before, the four Kumaras led by Sanaka.
多帕库尔看到，在和他们在一起的是他以前见过的库马尔四兄弟，包括萨纳坦的姑苏阿米。
So the four Kumaras, they usually reside, they stay on Tapaloka.
库马尔四兄弟一般是住在塔帕洛卡。
And Gop Kumar had been there, he had met them there before.
Gopa Kumar 此前去过塔帕卢卡，遇见过库马尔四兄弟。
And they're just as exalted as the residents of Brahmaloka.
他们的地位非常崇高，就像 Brahma Loka 的居民一样崇高。
They're empowered incarnations of the Lord.
他们是主被授予力量的化身。
So when Gopkumar saw them, his mind was attracted and he experienced immediately so much joy just by seeing them.
Gopa Kumar 一看到四兄弟，他的心意就被吸引了，他就体验到了一种喜乐的情怀。
And Gopkumar was so happy that he was not aware of anything else but them.
Gopa Kumar 他如此的欢乐，以至于他没有意识到。他四周发生的别的事情，
He couldn't think of anything else. He couldn't even think about things which were usually very dear to him.
他一切都想不起来了，甚至他最钟爱的事物，他也想不起来。
But then after a moment, he came back to his usual consciousness.
过了片刻，他又恢复了正常的知觉。
But he was not, he didn't have the courage to ask them to make him their servant.
但是他没有勇气来请求成为他们的仆人。
Gopkumar felt too afraid and embarrassed to ask for such a blessing.
Gopa Kumar 看上去，很胆怯，也觉得很难为情，祈求这种祝福。
Gopkumar thought it would be offensive. Because he thought he's just an insignificant person.
Gopa Kumar 觉得自己，是有做了冒犯，因为他觉得自己是这么微不足道的人物。
Yeah, he thought he was, he thought himself, he said, thought I'm not qualified to be a servant of these people from Vaikuntha.
Gopa Kumar 心想，自己没有资格去成为这些来自外昆他的人物的仆人。
So he said, he said he couldn't summon the courage to make the regulation. He couldn't find the courage to make his request to be their servant.
他无法鼓足勇气，要求成为他们的仆人。
So Lord Shiva, he embraced them when he saw the Vaikuntha people from Va the people from Vaikuntha. Lord Shiva embraced them, and just by embracing them, he went, he swooned in ecstasy of love of God.
主 Shiva 又拥抱了这些 Vaikuntha 的人们，他开始由于对神的狂喜之爱，他淹没在这个狂喜的爱当中。
But Gopkumar said he had something troubling him.
但 Gopa Kumar 说道："他自己。"就是有些东西呢，他觉得在打扰着他。
He had a longing in his mind that just once, by the mercy of Lord Shiva, that these persons would somehow talk to him.
他内心有一个夙愿，哪怕是一次，急着 Shiva 的仁慈，这些人可以开口对他讲话。
Or they might save him by the mercy of their glance.
或者是急着他们瞥视的仁慈，这些人可以拯救他。
Gop Kumar thought, only by the mercy of these wonderful people from Vaikuntha could he be saved from dying untimely.
只有急着这些来自百昆特的美妙人物的仁慈，他才不至于夭折。
So Gop Kumar didn't know who these people were. He didn't know where they had come from, but he could understand that they were great souls.
Gopa Kumar 不知道这些人物都是谁，来自何方，但他能够明白他们都是伟大的灵魂。
So Lord Shiva's wife, she always acts according to the desire of Lord Shiva, and she knows the heart of Lord Shiva.
主 Shiva 的妻子总是，她的行为举止总是能符合自己丈夫的心愿。她了解自己丈夫的心。
And she could also understand what Gop Kumar was thinking.
她也能明白 Gopa Kumar 的想法。
So she had her son Ganesh speak to Gop Kumar.
他就让自己的儿子 Ganesh 对 Gopa Kumar 开口讲话了。
Right. Lord Shiva and his wife Parvati, they have two sons. One is Ganesh, the other son is Kartikeya.
主 Shiva 和 Parvati 生了两个儿子，Ganesh 和 Kartikeya。
So Ganesh spoke to Gop Kumar in a very quiet voice.
Ganesh 便以一种平静的口吻对 Gopa Kumar 讲话。
He spoke very quietly because what he was going to say was very confidential.
他之所以悄悄地对 Gopa Kumar 说话，是因为这个内容是非常机密的。
He didn't want all the companions of Lord Shiva to hear.
他不希望主 Shiva 的所有同伴们听到。
Lord Shiva's wife, Parvati, she's always present in her husband's heart.
主 Shiva 的妻子 Parvati 总是最了解自己丈夫的心，在丈夫的心中。
And she only acts with the sanction of Lord Shiva. She will not do anything without Lord Shiva's sanction.
没有主 Shiva 的同意，Parvati 是不会做任何事情的。
So Ganesh said to Gop Kumar that these people are all associates of the ruler of Vaikuntha, who is the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna.
Ganesh 对 Gopa Kumar 说道："这些人都是 Vaikuntha 之主 Sri Krishna 的同游们。
And they've all got bodily forms like him, and they have come from Vaikuntha.
他们的身形都跟 Sri Krishna 一样，都跟 Vaikuntha 之主一样，都有同样的特征。"
And Lord Ganesh says to Gop Kumar, he said, just see these companions of the Lord. They're all from Vaikuntha.
Ganesh 对 Gopal Kumar 说道："看看主 主的这些同伴们，他们都是来自外昆塔。
But they're traveling in this small universe, which is under the rule of four-headed Brahma.
他们现在都在这一个小宇宙当中旅行，这个小宇宙是在四头的 Brahma 的统治之下。
And further away, there's another universe where there's an eight-headed Brahma. And that world is twice as large as ours.
除此之外，还有另一个宇宙是由八头的 Brahma 来统治的。这个宇宙的大小比我们这个宇宙是大一倍。
And there's another Brahma with 16 heads, and that universe is twice as large again.
还有另一个 Brahma，另一位 Brahma，他有16个头颅，而他的统治的宇宙又比前一个宇宙又大2倍。
Lord Ganesh wanted to show that these visitors from Vaikuntha were very extraordinary.
Ganesh 想要表明，来自 Vaikuntha 的这些拜访者们都是非同寻常的人物。Krishna.
Hare
Sorry.
Krishna. Oh,
Hare
Lord.
Krishna, can you hear me?
Yes, Maharaj.
Okay, so Ganesh pointed out to Gop Kumar that there were more of these Vaikuntha people coming in different from different directions.
Ganesh 向 Gopal Kumar 指出。还有更多的 Vaikuntha 的人物都来自四面八方，都来了。
And they were a great distance away. They were on some other mission.
他们在遥远的另一个地方，他们都在执行着某个使命。
So Gop Kumar was in this small universe where Brahma has only four heads.
话库尔，他处在一个小宇宙，这个小宇宙的统治者 Brahma 只有4个头颅。
But there were other Vaikuntha messengers who were visiting and they were visiting where the Brahma has eight heads.
有别的Vaikuntha 的信使们。他们是去拜访了有8个头的 Brahma 的宇宙。
And they were traveling very fast. Because that universe is so large.
他们以很快的速度在旅行着，因为那个宇宙是非常大的。
And Ganesh showed there was another universe with 16-headed Brahma.
Ganesh 又展示出有另一个宇宙的，他那个 Brahma 的有16个头颅。
So in this way, Ganesh showed Gop Kumar many Vaikuntha companions of the Lord.
就这样，Ganesh 展示出有许多的。 主的瓦昆特的同游们。
And they were all traveling very easily in millions and millions of universes.
他们都很轻而易举的在千百万个宇宙间旅行着。
Where there are many, many Brahmas who had millions and billions of lotus faces.
这些宇宙的统治者，Brahma，他们有百万，上亿的莲花脸。
So the Vaikuntha devotees were very attractive to everyone.
在每个人的眼里，这些瓦昆的奉献者都是非常有魅力的。
And they all had similar bodies, and they were all equipped with, or they were equipped for whatever universe they were visiting.
这些瓦昆德的奉献者都有同样的躯体特征，而且他们的随身装备用品都适合，便于他们在不同的宇宙旅行。
And so Lord Ganesh was showing all these different people from Vaikuntha in the different universes.
就 Ganesh 就一个又一个的展示了。在不同宇宙间的所有这些不同人物，
And there were so many uni there was an infinite number of universes, and in each universe there was Brahmas with different numbers of heads.
有无穷无尽的宇宙，而在不同这些宇宙间的 Brahma 又长着不同数量的头颅。
And Brahma's heads were so many in the bigger universes, they'd have more heads.
在更大的宇宙间的主 Brahma 的头颅的数量要更多得多。
So the scriptures have described countless numbers of universes.
在经典中描述说，有无数的宇宙。
Lord Brahma himself. In the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Brahma is speaking and he says, I'm just a small creature. I measure only seven spans of my own hand.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛当中，主 Brahma 就第十篇，主 Brahma 讲述说：“我只是这个，我只是，宇宙间的一个小生物，我的大小也只是，
Yeah, seven
只
times
是，
the size of my hand.
哦，只是我的，臂膀的七倍大的这样的身高。”
And I'm enclosed. I have to. I'm kept in a pot, a universe which is like a pot.
而我处在这个就好像一个陶罐一样的宇宙之中。
It's all composed of the material nature and the false ego and the earth and water and it and ether.
这些宇宙都是由物质元素，包括土、水。还有假自我构成的。
And Brahma addresses the Lord. He says to the Lord Krishna, he said, but what is your glory is unlimited universes come from the pores of your body.
主 Brahma 就向主 Krishna 献上祈祷说：“你的荣耀是无穷无尽的，这无数的宇宙都从你的毛孔中散发出来。
Universes are coming from your body just like particles of dust come through the opening of a screen window.
”从你的身体当中，这无穷无尽的宇宙就好像是。这个尘埃一样，尘埃穿过纱窗一样，从你的身体当中散发出来。
And then there's another verse also in the 10th canto of the Bhagavatam where Lord Brahma is saying that he's saying to Krishna that you are unlimited.
在圣殿波迦瓦坛第十篇当中，主 Brahma 就对 Krishna 祈祷说：“您是无限的。”
And the lords of heaven, in other words, the demigods, they cannot ever know all your glories. And even you yourself cannot know all of your glories.
他说：“即便是这些。”天堂之主，这些半神人们不了解您，甚至连你自己，您自己也不了解您自己的荣耀。
And there are countless universes all enclosed in a shell.
无限的宇宙都被包裹在一个外壳之内。
And they're forced by the wheel of time to wander within the shell.
在时间之轮的力量之下，他们被迫就在这个外壳覆盖层之内呢，在那里，在那里漫游着。
They're just like particles of dust blowing in the wind.
就好像在风中漂浮的这些一粒粒尘埃。
And the Vedas become successful. The Vedic knowledge becomes successful when you are revealed.
只有当您在韦达经中被揭示的时候，这些韦达知识被视为是成功的。
When we understand that you are the real object of the Vedas. Then our study of the Vedas is successful.
当我们明白，您是韦达经的目的所在的时候。我们对韦达经的研究才被视为是成功的。
In another verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, it says, every universe is covered by seven layers.
在圣殿波迦瓦坛另一个诗节当中说，每一个宇宙都有七个覆盖层。
Yeah, the seven layers are earth and water and fire.
这七个覆盖层分别是土层、水层、火层。
And then air and sky.
空气层、天空层。
And then there's the total energy and false ego.
还有整体能量以及假自我。
And each layer is 10 times the other one.
每一个覆盖层都是前一个覆盖层的10倍大。
So, in addition to our universe, there's an infinite number of other universes.
除了我们这个宇宙之外， 还有无穷无尽的宇宙。
And although they may be some of the universes are very big, they're still moving under your control.
尽管有些宇宙是非常庞大的，它们依然是在您的控制之下移动着。
And they move just like atoms in you.
他们就好像在你身体内的一粒原子。
So that's why we can understand that the Lord is known as Ananta, meaning unlimited.
因为这个原因，主以 Ananta 而著称，意思是无穷无尽之人。
From where, so Kumar had, he had gone beyond the material universe, so he was in the abode of liberation. So he could see all the different material universes.
在这个时候，库马已经超越了这个宇宙，他已经来到了解脱之地，所以能够看清所有的物质宇宙。
Yeah, from where he was standing, he was able to see everything.
从他所站立的地方，他可以清晰地瞥见一切。
Where he was everything. He was, there was no covering of material energy, so he could see everything.
从他所站立的地方，没有物质能量的覆盖，所以他可以清晰的看见一切。
And each universe he saw the Vaikuntha messengers had assumed forms with a different size and different powers.
而在每一个宇宙之中呢，都有这些百昆特的信使们，他们都长着不同的身体形象，他们有不同的身高，他们也有不同的力量。
So it was important that people from Vaikuntha had to make themselves suitable in size and form for each of the universes they were visiting.
重要的一点是，这些百昆特的信使们。他们的形身体的样貌，他们身体的高度，他们都应该适合他们拜访的每一个特定宇宙。
Otherwise, the people on those different universes would not receive them with the same respect which they deserve.
否则的话，他们拜访的宇宙的人们就不会以他们应有的尊重来迎接他们。
Because they're all representatives of Lord Narayan.
因为他们全都是主 Narayan 的代表。
So Lord Ganesh said to Gop Kumar, he said, these persons, they're attached only to devotional service to the Lord.
但那时对哥帕库马尔说道：“这些人一心一意的，唯一依附的就是对主的奉献服务。
And they're able to travel wherever they like to go to spread pure devotion.
他们可以，随自己的喜好到任何地方旅行，来传播纯粹的奉爱。”
They save the Lord's devotees from all dangerous situations.
他们把主的奉献者从各式各样的危险境地当中解救出来。
They, even at the time of death, they will come and help the devotee.
甚至在奉献者临终之际，他们也会来帮助奉献者。
The devotee may just have only a reflection of the Lord's name on the tip of their tongues, but these devotees from Vaikuntha will come and save them.
哪怕这些临终之际的奉献者，在舌尖上，他们，圣明的，哪怕是一点点的影子，只是反射在这些临终奉献者的舌尖上，那这些白昆塔的奉献者都会来拯救、营救他们。
So Lord Ganesh is explaining why the messengers from Vaikuntha are traveling everywhere, visiting the different universes.
但那时，就解释了百昆达的信使们为什么在各个地方旅，在不同宇宙当中在旅行着。
They were acting on their own initiative. Haribo?
Hare Krishna，他们这些人，都是自发的、自主的在那里旅行着。
Yeah, they travel everywhere just to spread devotional service to the Lord.
他们到处旅行，来传播对主的奉献服务。
And by their presence, the devotees don't they don't have any fear.
由于他们的临在，奉献者们内心就无所畏惧。
Of course, a Vaishnava doesn't have anything to fear from anything material.
当然，外施那瓦们，他们对于任何物质的境况都无所畏惧。
But they do fear obstructions to their bhakti.
他们害怕、担心的是对他们的父爱 bhakti 的阻碍。
So the Vaikunthavasis always try to help the Vaishnavas to overcome that fear.
所以这些 Vaikunthavasi 无忧星宿的居民们就帮助 Vaishnava 来克服对这种恐惧、对父爱的障碍。
And these Vaikunthavasis, the people from Vaikuntha, they will protect anyone who has just once chanted or heard the holy name.
哪怕一个人一生当中只是，哪怕只唱诵和聆听了主的圣名一次，这些百昆塔的居民们都能保护这些人。
Even a shadow of his name, if it's uttered neglectfully, they will help. They want to help that person.
哪怕哪个人，他只是念诵的只是圣名的影子。都能得到这些 Vaikuntha Vasi 的帮助。
All right. And then Lord Ganesh speaks about the four Kumaras. He said they are the best of lifelong celibates, and they're incarnations of the Lord's. They're the Lord's incarnation, and they've come as devotees.
在那时，又接着介绍了库马尔四兄弟，说：“他们这个四兄弟都是，毕生都是真守生，他们是主的化身，但是他们却以奉献者的姿态来降临了。”
And wander for the benefit of all the living entities everywhere.
他们四处旅行。只是为了所有众生的福祉，
They're just like the people from Vaikuntha.
他们就跟百昆塔的人们是一样的。
Their residents, they actually live on Tapaloka.
他们实际上的居所是在 Tapaloka。
And there they give they help the people to feel secure, because sometimes they feel helpless in the absence of Lord Narayan.
他们在那里是来帮助人们有一种安全感，因为在主 Narayana 不在的情况下，人们会有一种无助感。
So Gop Kumar may have been wondering why the four Kumaras had come with all the people from Vaikuntha.
Gopa Kumar 可能在奇怪，为什么？Sorry, Mark.
The four Kumaras, why did
Yeah.
they come with the people from Vaikuntha?
Oh, Gopa Kumar 可能想要了解为什么 Kumar 师兄弟和 Vaikuntha 的人们一起来了呢？
So the messengers of Vaikuntha are servants of the Lord of Vaikuntha.
Vaikuntha 无忧星宿的信使们都是无忧星宿之主的仆人。
And the four Kumaras, they are Shaktavesha avatars of the same Lord.
而库玛尔四兄弟又是同一位主的 Shakti Vishwa Avatar，就是灌注能量的化身。
And by their own example, the Kumaras, they helped to promote the cause of Lord Narayan's devotional service.
即使他们的榜样，库玛尔他们在提升着，在推广着朱纳让的奉爱服务。
So most of the time, the four Kumaras will live on Tapaloka, because the people there depend on them. They depend on their guidance.
大部分时间，库玛尔四兄弟居住在塔帕罗卡，因为那里的人们在依赖着他们的指导。
The people who live up there in Tapaloka, they're all lifelong celibates and they practice yoga.
在塔帕罗卡上面的人们都是终生的真守生，他们在习练着瑜伽。
So the Kumaras teach them how to practice yoga, and they also create for them the best association, because they're always speaking about the Lord.
马尔斯兄弟教导着塔帕洛卡的人们瑜伽，并且为他们创造好运，提供涟漪。他们也总是在讲述着主。
And they get them to chant the glories of the Lord.
他也让人们来去唱颂主的荣耀。
And when Lord Vishnu is away from Tapaloka, then the residents, they all suffer, they feel the pain of the separation from the Lord.
当主 Vishnu 离开 Tapaloka 的时候，Tapaloka 的居民都因为和主的分离而感到悲伤。
They feel like they've lost contact with the Lord when he leaves, when he goes away.
当主离开的时候，他们感觉的都和主失去了联系。
But in their meditation, because they're always doing meditation, they practice Ashtanga yoga, so they're always doing meditation, so they always see the Lord.
但是，因为他们总在练习着八部瑜伽，因此在他们冥想当中，他们能够看见主。
So, Ganesh, Lord Ganesh says to Gop Kumar that these four brothers, they had just gone to Vaikuntha and they had just seen the Supreme Lord.
Ganesh 对 Gopa Kumar 说：“这四兄弟呢，刚刚去外昆塔见到了主。
So they filled themselves. They're full of ecstasy, much higher than any of the happiness you could get from liberation.
他们自己的内心所充斥着狂喜之情。 这些狂喜之情远远高于解脱带来的快乐。
And they taste the nectar of pure devotion to the Lord in the company of his devotees.
在这些奉献者的陪伴下，他们品尝着对主的纯粹奉爱之情。
So Sanat Kumar and his brothers were traveling with the messengers of Vaikuntha.
Sanat Kumar 和他的兄弟们就和 Vaikuntha 的信使们一道旅行。
And they were just coming back from there. So they came back along with the other people coming from Vaikuntha.
所以他们就和 Vaikuntha 的其他人就一起回来了。
So the four Kumaras are all Atmaramas, they're self-satisfied.
四位库玛尔兄弟都是 Atmarama，是自我满足的灵魂。
And the qualities of Lord Vishnu are so great that even though people are self-satisfied, they'll be attracted by Lord Vishnu.
主威逊的品质是如此伟大，以至于甚至吸引了这些自我满足的灵魂。
So the four Kumaras had gone to Vaikuntha and they'd seen the Lord in person and they felt ecstasy.
所以，四位库玛尔四兄弟才去百昆塔去见到主，他们便感到狂喜。
They felt they felt the happiness of that happiness of seeing the Lord was much greater than any kind of happiness in personal liberation.
他们见到主，感受到的快乐是远远高于非人格解脱的快乐。
And they had chanted the Lord's glories in the association with the Vaikuntha devotees.
他们就在百昆的无忧星宿奉献者的陪伴之下，一起唱颂着主的荣耀。
So they felt the nectar of Bhakti Ras.
他们在品味、体验着 Bhakti Rasa 奉爱的甘露。
All right, so we stop here today.
正课就讲到这里。第一个有问题，雅洁，哎呦，不是 Rama Yagya。If a Brahma has more heads, does it mean the universe is more opulent?
No. Yeah, go ahead.
如果 Brahma 有更多的头，是不是说这个宇宙更富裕？
No, not necessarily. It just means it's bigger in size.
不一定，只说它的宇宙的尺寸更大，它的体积更大。下一个问题是何家权。百昆特居民是根据所拜访的各个不同宇宙变化形体，还是特定形体的居民，只拜访特定的宇宙呢？So may I ask, those Vaikuntha Vasi assume different bodily forms to visit different universes.
Yes.
Or is it the reason is that they have their own special forms, therefore they according to their own special forms they visit special universes.
No.
Is 根据他。Yes, ma'am.
They take the form required for the particular universe that they're going to.
他们是根据所拜访的各个不同宇宙，所以才变化成特定的形体。
Yeah, they're just like in a universe, there are different planets, or even on one planet, we get different races. Some races are tall, some races are small size, and people have different features. So different universes, there are also different bodily forms and different sizes.
在宇宙，每个宇宙当中都有不同的星体，而不在一个星球上也有不同的民族生活在那里。有的民族身体高大，而有的民族身体矮小，有不同的身体特征。所以，不同的宇宙他们有自身的，就是他们的居民有自身的身高。书体如何说？顶拜谦姑和老师们，第一，戈帕库马尔在不同星球旅行的时候，需要穿越不同的覆盖层吗？他旅行中的时间长度怎么计算呢？So may I ask that when Gopa Kumar travel in different travel on various planets. Does Gopal Kumar cross over different layers of coverings?
No, he doesn't cross the layers of coverings until he goes out of the universe.
不是的，是只有当 Gopal Kumar，他需要到宇宙的最高星球的时候，它才要穿过不同的覆盖层。它旅行中的长度怎么计算？How to calculate the time of the traveling？
How to calculate the time of the traveling. Well, sometimes he will travel very fast, and sometimes it depends where he's traveling to.
这取决于他，旅行到哪个地方，有时候是很快的。
When he was going, when he was traveling from Braja. When he was going to the different places in the universe, he would go from one planet to another planet. But at another point, he went right outside the universe. So when he went right outside the universe, he passed all the places which he'd traveled to before, and he passed them very quickly.
有两种情况，一种情况是当他在一个宇宙之中旅行的时候，他需要一个又一个的，从一个星球旅行到另一个星球。有另外一种情况是，当他在一个已经穿越，他已经穿越了一个物质宇宙的时候，他来到宇宙，他要去宇宙之外，他会很快的就穿越。第二，既然我们在地球只有一个脑袋，就如此骄傲，请问那些拥有更多脑袋的生物，他们靠苦行功德，还是什么原因进入那么高的星球呢？这些和他们回归守神有关系吗？Since we are so proud, we have only one head on this earth. So may I ask those living entities who have more heads, what's the reason for them to enter into such sublime planets? What merits do they depend on what kind of tapasya and past activity can they enter into such higher planetary system?
Well, you go to higher planetary systems by pious activities.
一个人只有通过虔诚的功德，才可以进入到高等的星球。
Just like Tapaloka, where the four Kumaras came from, they practice lifelong celibacy.
就像塔帕卢卡，这个是库马尔四兄弟他们就从这个塔帕克卢卡来的，在这上面的居民呢，他们毕生都是遵守的。这些和他们回归守神有关系吗？So, are there any relationship between, What's the relationship between those past activity and going back to Godhead? Are there any relationship?
Well, pious activities will keep you in the material world. But going back to Godhead, you have to have pure love for God.
虔诚活动。只会把一个人让一个人继续停留在物质世界，而要回归神手，需要的是对神手的纯粹的爱。第三，我们应该是以回归神手为目的、为目标，还是单纯只是感恩、取悦、咕噜和主来使用自己的生命呢？Should we only our only goal is to go back to Godhead, or should we only think about showing gratitude to please Guru and the Lord in that way to use our lifespan? She's asking, what should be our thoughts? Should we only think about going back to Godhead, or should we think about to spend our life to please the Lord, please Guru and the Lord in gratitude?
Yes, well, better to please the Lord in gratitude.
是的，最好，更好的是怀着感恩去取悦主。
If you only think about going back to Godhead, that is just you're thinking about your own self. But if
如
we
果
think about pleasing the Lord, I think pleasing the Lord is higher than just thinking about your own deliverance.
如果，以回归神手为目标，一心一意是回归神手，那么这时，只是还是想着的是自己，那你的思一个人的思维是还是围绕自己，但是以取悦主为来去使用自己的生命呢，要高于想着自己的解脱。Rama Yagya. After this life, can we join the pastime of Krishna in a different universe? Or is it only the external associates of Krishna that can join this of Krishna's pastimes? What are the qualifications needed? 在这生之后，我们能不能在一个不同的宇宙加入 Krishna 的逍遥时光，或者是只是 Krishna 的外在同游？ 可以加入 Krishna 的小时光，需要的是什么样的资格？
Yes, you can take part in Krishna's pastimes. You can also become an eternal associate of Krishna.
是的，您可以加入主的消时光，您可以成为主 Krishna 的永恒同游。
你可以成为 Krishna 永恒的朋友。
成为
你
Krishna。
Yes, conditioned souls can also become eternally liberated souls.
就是受矫健体困的灵魂，也可以成为永恒解脱的灵魂。
So, conditioned souls can also, when they develop pure love for Krishna, they can enter into Krishna's pastimes and associate with Krishna.
所以，体困灵魂，他们倘若是发展了对 Krishna 的纯爱之后，就可以加入 Krishna 的逍遥，成为 Krishna 的同游。第二，other than Goloka and Vaikuntha Nath, are there also other universes in the spiritual world? 在灵性世界，除了 Goloka 和 Vaikuntha 之外，还有没有别的宇宙？
Where do you go? Vaikuntha is there's an infinite number of universes in Vaikuntha.
在百昆塔已经是有无穷无尽的宇宙了。下一个问题是阿特玛，
Atmavata.
阿特玛瓦塔迪达西王文言，顶拜 Guru 和所有奉献者。Guru 对刚才讲到，只要念诵一句 Hare Krishna 的人，都会得到主的救赎。那是不是意味着我们不要有太多恐惧，接受生活中的发生，但遵守四项规范原则，而同时坚持持续的做奉爱服务，就能得到 Krishna 的救赎呢？Obeisance to Guru and all devotees, Gurudev, you just mentioned by only once chanting Hare Krishna, one can be delivered by Lord. Does that mean that we should not have so many fear in our life? We just accept whatever happened in our life, but at the same time, we follow four regular principles and to keep on doing devotional service. In that way, we'll get deliverance of Krishna.
Yes, you can get deliverance of Krishna that way.
是的，以这种方式，您可以得到 Krishna 的救赎。
You just
Present。
follow the four regulative principles, chant 16 rounds minimum, try to avoid offenses every day. Try to improve the quality of your chanting.
你需要人一个人需要遵守四项规范原则，每天念诵至少16圈，每天努力的去避免冒犯，每天努力的去提升念诵的质量。Prasanta Devadasi Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 顶拜所有奉献者。Vaikuntha 的 Karti 也是主 Krishna 的化身吗？他主管什么事务？恳请 Guru 开示。So Hare Krishna Guru, the Karti in Vaikuntha is also whether or not is also an incarnation of Lord Krishna, and also, what?
Kalki.
Yes.
Does she mean the Kalki who is the avatar, Yuga avatar, who comes at the end of Kali Yuga?
Santa Devadasi，您说的这位 Karki 是指的是在年代之末， 化身前来的这位 Karki 是吗？请您开一下麦。那、no，他还没有回答。She said，我也不懂。I don't understand.
Well, there are tell her there are 10 avatars, dasa avatars of Lord Krishna. Jayadeva Goswami has written a song about 10 avatars, and one of them is Kalki, who comes at the end of the Kali Yuga.
Jayadeva Goswami 就写了一首诗，Dasa Avatar 的歌曲，描述了主的十个化身，其中有一个是在卡利年代结束的时候的化身，名字叫 Kalki。
Yeah, and he is predicted that when he comes, he will take a horse and he will ride a horse and he will carry a sword and he will kill all the demons who are remaining at the end of Kali Yuga.
在预言当中，就这样说：当他来的时候，他会骑着一匹马，他手持宝利剑，会杀死在卡里年代剩下的所有恶魔们。
And so all the demons will be killed and then they'll begin Satya Yuga.
这样，剩下的恶魔们全都被铲除，一扫而光，然后萨提亚年代。黄金年代又会开始了。
So that's Kalki Avatar, Kalki, who comes at the end of the Kali Yuga.
这就是 Kalki 化身，它降临的年代是在卡利年代结束的时候。
He's a Yuga avatar.
它是一位年代化身。那我们下一个是 Chaitanya Rupa Devadasi 顶拜 Gurudev 在瓦坛3.28.6中说，六个生命之气循环圈是脉轮吗？是七脉轮还是六个？那圣田波迦瓦坛，也是曼巴瓦坛。3.28.6. It mentions six cycle of six kind of life air. So may I ask, is it six or seven? Check，第三篇，第28章，it's Kapila's instruction on exit，
Yeah. Well, if it says six, then it must be six.
It says，如果说的是六个圈，那
What chapter is it?
chapter 28，
Chapter 28, right? And what's the verse number?
six。
Okay. Let me see. One of the six circles of vital air. Why does she think it should be seven?
那这里说有6个生命之气循环圈，那您为什么说到七个？
It says six circles. There are six circles. The purport says also six circles of vital air circulating within the body.
这里说到，要指躯体中有六个生命之气的循环圈。
The first circle is within the belly. The second circle is in the area of the heart.
其中第
The
一个
mind.
圈子，
The third is in the area of the lungs.
就是在要旨当中说，他爸说，第一个圈是在腹部，第二圈在心脏部位，第三个圈在肺部。
Then the fourth is on the tongue, the palate.
第四个圈在上颚部。
The fifth is between the eyebrows.
第五个圈在两眉间，
And the sixth is the highest, that is above the brain.
第六个圈，也就是最高的圈在头顶。
So why she thinks it's seven?
那您为什么想有七个圈？
It's very clearly mentioned six, and they're all told to us.
这里清晰的说到，提到是有六个圈，而且都很详细的讲述了。
Okay.
Annie，顶拜 Guru 和奉献者们，请问 Guru，念诵一声主的圣名就能得到主的救赎。这里的救赎指的是这个人这辈子就能得到救赎吗？这里的救赎指的是回到主的星球还是什么？Guru, by only once chanting the Lord's holy name, one can get Lord's deliverance. What does the deliverance, as far as the deliverance is concerned, does that refer to that in this life one can get delivered, or does it refer to one can go back to Lord's planet or anything else?
Well, when it says once chanting, you should understand that there's quality in that once chanting, that you have to chant the name purely without offense.
那这里说到一次。念诵一声主的圣名，那么这里还有包括它的品质，就是念诵的品质在内。这指的是念诵的是纯粹的圣名，而且是没有冒犯的念诵的。
If you chant at the intermediate stage, the stage of Namabhas, then that can get you liberation, that can get you to above the modes of nature. But it doesn't get you love of God.
那么，如果就是在念诵圣名，有一个阶段是中间阶段，叫 Namabhas 阶段。在这个阶段的念诵，一个人可以得到解脱，也就是意味着他超越了物质的属性，但是他还得不到对神手的爱。
So you have to understand that you want to, if you want, according to the quality of your chanting, you'll get different results.
所以要明白的是，根据念诵的品质，会得到不同的相应的结果。Nimai Nitai Devadasi 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 顶拜奉献者，感内室有大象的头是吗？那么感内室和象王感真者。是完全不同、不相关的吗？Nitai Nimai is asking, whether Ganesh had a head of elephant, and What's the relationship between Ganesh and Gajendra?
Gajendra.
Yes. Yeah,
I'm
are there
no
any
connect.
relationship?
No. No
没有，没
relation.
有，对，没有，是不同的，不相关的。
Ganesh has an elephant head. Gajendra is an elephant body.
Ganesh 是长着象头，而 Gajendra 呢，它是一个象，大象的躯体。
So,
Bloody，
there's no connection.
没有关系。Lalita Prishta Gopi Devadasi Dima Guru，您提到四维库玛尔是 Atma Rama，自我解脱的灵魂，但是见到主之后感到快乐，远高于非人格的解脱。我的问题是，Atma Rama 是指哪个层面的解脱？五种解脱层面的灵魂都是这么称呼吗？Guru，the four Kumars。You mentioned they are Atma Rama, self-satisfied soul, but they have felt much more happiness when they meet the Lord. And the happiness is far, far much more than the impersonal liberation. So my question is, one, the first, so on which level those Atma Rama, they are situated on which level, in which level of liberation? So there are five kinds of liberation. The five kinds of the souls, liberated souls, they are situated
Well,
in five.
the four Kumaras, they're generally their Shantarasa.
四库玛尔他们通常而言，他们是处在 Shanta Ras 中性关系。
Santarasa means they appreciate the beauty of the Lord, they're attracted by the opulence of the Lord, but they don't do any service.
这个 Shanta Ras 是指的。他们欣赏主的美丽，他们被主的富裕所吸引，但是他们不做服务。您提到四库玛尔在自己的星球修习八部瑜伽，主柴塔涅会降临那里，赐予 Hare Krishna 简易程序吗？还是他们的特殊使命，就是要扮演这个角色呢？不需要像我们局限的灵魂一样接受这个程序。The four Kumars they practice Ashtanga Yoga on their own planets. Will Lord Chaitanya descend there to give them the easy process of chanting Hare Krishna?
No.
不会.
Lord Chaitanya comes here.
So, Chaitanya 降临这里. Xia 一个问题是 Chaitanya Rupa. So she's also asking the four Kumars whether they have to play a special role and they have their own special mission. So in that way, there's no need for them to take up this easy process of chanting Hare Krishna.
Yes, right. They have their own process. Their process is meditating on the Lord.
是的，库马尔斯兄弟他们有他们自己的程序， 他们的程序就是冥想主。Chaitanya Rupa 周末联谊，同时给寺院派送了 prasadam。我很想给住持众生唱诵主的圣名，但奉献者忠告我不要唱，只派灵粮。但我还是想下次送 prasadam 时把圣名给他们。Guru，您说唱还是不唱？
Well, I don't know. You have to consider the situation. Where are you? What kind of place is it?
这个我不知道，您得考虑，您的实际情况，看您是在哪里，而且是处在什么样的境况当中。
You don't want to get trouble.
毫无疑问，您不想给自己找麻烦。
You want to give prasadam. Sometimes you have to give prasadam, you have to do it discreetly. People will wonder why you're doing it, why you're giving this, what's happening. It's not usual.
有时候您想派 prasadam 的，您还得悄悄的做，因为人们会纳闷儿，为什么要给呀？这很不正常。
Okay.
下一个是杏儿，咕噜，请问，门徒没有解脱，灵性导师就会一直来这个世界带门徒回去，那帕帕德的门徒都是解脱了吗？所以他要不要再回来？
Well. We cannot say all of Prabhupada's disciples are liberated.
我们不能说帕帕德所有的门徒都解脱了。
Some people took initiation and then they gave up practice.
有些人得到启迪之后，放弃了这种修行。
Some people may practice a little bit, they may still be devotee, but they're not practicing very actively.
有些他们只是，就少的做了少量的服务，他们可能还是奉献者。但他们并不活跃。
Yeah. Their devotion is mixed with many material things.
他们的奉爱混杂了许多的物质成分。
But they're all on the devotee path. They're on the path, so they're connected to Prabhupada by some good fortune, and we hope that they will become liberated. Yeah.
他们都在这条道路上，都和由于好运和帕帕德连在一起。希望他们能够获得解脱，终会获得解脱。So she's asking, so if the disciple, disciples, one disciple haven't get liberation, so the spiritual master will keep on going
Well,
back.
he may not personally come, but he may arrange for somebody else to come.
他灵性导师可能不会亲自来，带门徒回去，但是他会安排别人来。柴天尼亚，如果说，现在的瑜伽书上写的都是七个，还有一个海底轮。As far as the seventh circle of life air is concerned, it is all mentioned in the yoga books mentioned there are seven chakra. The one is the bottom chakra, the ocean chakra.
The what?
海底轮。Called
The ocean.
海里，Let me check how to say
Heidi.
it. 海底，
Land water.
Underwater whale.
Underwater. Well, maybe that's the impersonalist. I don't know.
叫 root
There it is.
chakra muladhara base chakra muladhara chakra我不知道，也许
Well,
这个是非人格的。
I don't know. I'm certainly Papa's books is six there.
在帕帕德的要旨当中写了16个。
I can check in Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's translation. We'll see what he says. Commentaries.
我会去，在 Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur 的著作，他的翻译和评论当中去再去看一下，看他是怎么写的。Atma Vata 王文言 Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 奉献者的莲花组，荣耀归于帕帕的莲花组。请问 Guru Dev 经典上说，女人的力量是顺从和宽容。那么在卡利年代，女人对长辈和丈夫的顺从怎么界定？过了，假如，过年了，假如长辈要求我们买蛋或者做肉，怎么办？怎么顺从？So Guru Dev, in the scripture, the women are supposed to be submissive and tolerant, but in Kali Yoga, how to define the submissiveness of the woman. For example, the spring festival, the seniors and husband demand that we buy eggs and to cook meat. So what should we do? How to show our submissiveness and tolerance?
Well, submissive and tolerance means in relation to our principle, religious principles. But it doesn't mean that you have to do things like buy meat and cook meat and eggs and stuff just for some materialistic husband.
这个女人的顺从和宽容呢，应该是和宗教原则，密切联系在一起，而不是说，就是顺从物质的丈夫，宽容是这个。不是跟物质的，就是在物质的丈夫面前展示出这宽容和顺从。
So being submissive and tolerant is, of course, husband is there. You have to tolerate these things. It doesn't mean you have to go and do them yourself.
但因为，丈夫，还是有丈夫的，所以就意味着你得容忍他们的行径，但并不意味着你就自己就和他们做的一样。
I mean, this is your karma. You married this man. You took this man as a husband, and now you want to change. Now you want him to stop doing things, all the things which you've been doing, you were doing with him for so many years. Now you want to stop. So this is your karma.
那即使你的丈夫你嫁给他，然后呢，你现在想改变了，想就是下来也就是不这么做了，但是你在这么多年了，都在一直和他做着这些事情。
So I checked in the Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's commentary, and they don't mention how many chakras. It just says one should fix the prana at one spot among the various chakras by the mind. It doesn't mention the chakras. They just said the chakras. It didn't say how many chakras.
提到了说，人应该将他的生命之气，让他生命之气在这个曼轮当中运行，但是他没有提到有多少个chakra。
In the purport, it says, among the places where prana is situated, starting with the Muladhara chakra. So starting with the Muladhara chakra, that's where the prana is situated. So maybe it's from the Muladhara chakra there are six, but you mentioned some other chakra, and there's no prana there.
这个钥匙当中说，就是从 Muladhara chakra 从海底轮，这个人的生命之气是在海底轮，在这里在运行着，在转着旋转着的，
Is Muladhara chakra Haidi Lun?
Yes.
Oh, that is the first one, huh?
Yes.
Okay, so he doesn't mention how many chakras there are, but he says from the Muladhara chakra. And you say that's Haidi Lun.
Yes.
So starting with the Muladhara Chakra, Haidi Lun. I don't know. Okay.
好，那我们看下一个问题。Chaitanya Rupa Guru，解脱是修习 Krishna 之学的副产品，修到位可以不要不求自得吗？Liberation is the byproduct of practicing Krishna consciousness. So, can I understand that if we have successful in practicing Krishna consciousness, then liberation will come automatically?
No, liberation is not important for the world.
对奉献者来说，解脱并不重要。
Devotees are already liberated. If you, as soon as you come to the platform of transcendence, as soon as you start to chant Hare Krishna and take up serious devotional life, then you're liberated soul.
就奉献者已经解脱了，而且奉献服务是超然的。一旦一个人开始唱诵 Hare Krishna，认真的做奉献服务。他就是一个解脱灵魂。
Devotional service begins on the liberated platform.
奉献服务是从解脱这个层面才开始去做的。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "Mam chayo vayabhicharena bhakti." Krishna says, "Brahma Bhuta prasanna ma." So to come to begin devotional service, we have to come to the Brahma Bhuta stage. Brahma Bhuta is the stage of liberation. So devotional service begins from the liberated platform.
在不下方歌就说到了 Brahma Bhuta Prasanatma 奉献服务就是从这个层面上在开始的。所以，Brahma Bhuta 这个层面就是解脱的层面，指的。
Okay.
Prasanta Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 奉献者，我昨天参加了非奉献者活动，让我唱歌，我唱了你生下祷文。我说是印度歌曲，可是有个奉献者等我唱完，告诉大家这是曼陀罗。 并且解释了 Hari 的意思 Krishna。当时很多人是无神论者，佛教徒、基督徒。我说他不合时宜，他说反正已经说了，这样的奉献者做得对吗？恳请 Guru 开示。Yesterday, there is an event organized by non-devotee. There are Buddhist Christianities, and they asked me to sing, and I sing the Nisheena prayer, and I told them it's an Indian song. But as soon as I finished singing, one devotee began to explain to everyone about the mantra. What is Hari? What is Krishna? And I told him and told her that it's not proper, but she doesn't agree with me. So Guru, is she doing the right thing?
Well, I don't know. I don't think it was very proper that she did that.
我就是他这么做呢，我觉得有点欠妥。
Yeah. I mean, she wasn't asked to give a talk. She wasn't, nobody was asked to explain, and you didn't chant Hare Krishna, you chanted the Nisheena prayer. And they asked you to sing a song, they didn't ask you to preach. I don't know.
这个具体的呢，就是因为他没有人邀请他来发表演讲，然后而且呢，你也没有唱诵，您并没有念唱的 Hare Krishna，只是唱了你生的祷文，而且呢，也没有人请求你去那里布道。那具体的来说，我不知道。The next one，最后一个是李海华，还有一个麦伦，在六麦伦外面的一个光圈，这也算是一个。It is comment addition。李海华 said, "There's also a chakra that is outside." The sixth chakra, and it is a culture.
Okay.
It is a
Aperture.
aperture. So it is also counted as a one chakra.
Where is it?
She said, outside the sixth chakra, she said there is a chakra that is outside the sixth chakra. So it's also a chakra. She said.
Oh, okay.
That's all the question.
That's all the questions.
That's
Okay, so then we will stop here today.
No.
Mama Ganshi Guru Mani Madhiji Ki Mami Pani Ganshi Panma Mukhi Ganshi Stoyra Functionza Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Maharaj. Vaikuntha 之音服务员已聆听。我们非常非常感谢圣Bhakti Vignaveenasana Singha Swami Nasingha Maharaj 给我们带来的早课。谢谢 Padmukhi 的主持，谢谢所有奉献者。Hare Krishna。
Jai Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.